Welcome to ROCKCOTE TV.
In this video, you will learn how to identify the absorbency of different types of brick and how to identify if a key coat will be required prior to the application of your render system. There are several different types of brick, and it is important to be able to identify the differences between them and to understand how they need to be treated prior to the application of your render system. Gary Hill, ROCKCOTE's technical advisor, will talk you through this process.
Use the water to find out what it's going to do. We all should moisten our substrate prior to rendering anyway. It helps with the curing and adhesion process. If you don't wet the substrate and prior to applying your render, if the moisture gets pulled out of the render too quickly, that'd be the initial rate of absorption, it will affect the bond and the curing of the render. So potentially the render won't cure, will become crumbly, possibly delaminate. So it's very important to identify that initial rate of absorption, control the moisture, keep the moisture in so we get a good chemical physical bond to the substrate. At times this may entail applying a key coat. With some bricks that have got not too much absorption, just give it or wet the wall down a lot more. But definitely wait until the sheen goes off the wall, and especially in dry, hot weather, make sure you have enough moisture in there that's not going to take moisture out of the render and cause it not to cure properly. If they see the render drying through the day, it's a good idea to give it a light hose, just a light mist to keep the moisture in the render to help the hydration process. Quite often that can be done before you go home of an evening. This brick, you can see the coarse nature of it. It's got open spores. That'll be ideal for a key to render. So yeah, you'd have to do a water test on that to make sure it's not going to suck in too fast.
To conduct a water test to identify the absorbency of your bricks, simply use your hose or water spray to wet the brick.
So a nice slow suction is the ideal to render over. If the water beads up and just runs down the wall, potentially silicon, or rather smooth, no suction. But these smooth face bricks, these are ones that, because that face is so smooth, we shouldn't really be even considering doing the water test. You'd be putting a key coat or a scratch coat on it first to get adhesion. If you do put your render straight onto that brick and then you go to finish it, it'll just probably more than likely just slide off because it's only sitting on the surface. It can't physically bind into the surface. Key coat, if there's too much suction, if the water's taken out of it, the brick has sucked the water too fast, because that won't leave moisture within the brick to enable the render to properly bind and cure. So essentially what we want is in the liquid, the water and cement, to slightly etch into the surface of the brick to gain the absorption, the bond, the physical bond. If the render can't get the physical bond, it's just going to hang there, probably knock it and it'll fall off. One other critical thing, quite often you'll come to some jobs and they'll have multiple bricks in the one wall. Safest thing to do to get an even suction is key coat the whole wall first. So if in doubt, put a key coat or a scratch coat on to get your physical bond. If there is any doubt, like if you get the little water beading up in little round balls, probably silicon, call us and we'll try and find a solution of which one of our render systems may work.
For technical advice or other queries, you can contact ROCKCOTE on our toll-free number or send us an email.